Hey there, I'm Cooper with Productive Robotics, and in this video, we're going to expand on the pick and place jobs we've already learned how to build using the handle and the tile system. Now, as simple as those jobs are, they're actually the foundation for more complicated projects like the ones you're going to build for your own jobs. Instead of picking up and placing at a single point, I'm going to show you how to teach OB7 to pick up parts in a grid and then place them in a stack. And we're going to do it by editing our previous job, which, of course, is a big time saver. So let's look at the tablet and pull up the job that we want to expand upon. The name for ours is PNP, so select Learn and then the name of your job. And then once you're in there, you'll see the tiles just like last time. Your pickup, your move, your place. We're going to start with the pickup tile. Select that. And then on the right side, you'll see you have four options underneath type. Naturally, it's selected to single. There's also stack, grid, and random. So we want to build a grid. As you can guess, we're going to select grid. Once you've chosen that, scroll down a bit until you see grid details. You're going to see four options, top left, top right, and bottom left. It's oriented as you face me. So this is our top left, our top right, so on and so forth. To teach OB7 this grid, we're just going to move our handle into place. Once the gripper's where we want it, we'll close it and select top left. Then at the bottom, select set pickup point.
Top left pickup point learned.
So OB7's learned our first spot. We still have to teach the three others, but instead of opening the gripper, leaving the part there, picking up each part each time, I'm just going to move it out of the way, leave the gripper closed, and swing this guy over here. You can do that for each part. It'll save you a little bit of time, and it's extra precise, which is obviously something that we want. So select top right, and then set pickup point. And then keep going. There are two bottom positions as well. Bottom right, set pickup point. And then our bottom left.
Bottom left. Pick
up point learned. So OB7's almost there in picking up the grid, but we still need to teach it what the parameters and dimensions of our grid are. So you'll see quantity wide and quantity high just beneath our four grid options. Go ahead and type in the dimensions for us. It's pretty obviously a 2x2, so 2 in wide and 2 in high. And at this point, OB7 knows enough to pick up all four of these pieces in their grid formation, and then set them down in that one single spot that we taught it in the original pick and place job. Let's go ahead and see how that works. Select work and then go. You get an idea of seeing how the grid process looks. Now this would be great if you have a conveyor system or a part bin and you're trying to just move things from here to there and let it run unattended for a while. But there's also the possibility you want to do something on a tabletop or something of that variety. And you're naturally going to want to save space. So we can do that by teaching OB7 how to build a stack. So go ahead and we'll get this reset. And we're going to go ahead and edit just like we would otherwise. The beauty, though, of the stack is that we don't have to teach the handle anything. We can do this all with just a few numbers. So once again, select Learn, your job name, PNP for us. And then from the tiles, we selected the pickup tile last time. Now it's going to be the place tile. Again, you have four options under type. We're going to select stack this time and scroll down to stack details. Just a few things we got to punch in. Our stack quantity is 4. Our part thickness for this is 19.05 millimeters. And then once you've tapped that in, select anywhere in the screen and the stack height will automatically populate. So now OB7 knows exactly enough to pick up in the grid and build that stack 4 high. Select go. You can see here we are. So now OB7 will be able to run the same job of picking up parts in a grid, but this time it'll place them in a stack with the location and quantities that we entered in the tablet. It's pretty cool, right? Like we've been discussing in each video thus far, OB7 has an incredible degree of flexibility, starting with basic functions like pick and place jobs that can be modified and built out to tackle whatever job that you have in mind. Once you jump in and get the hang of it, possibilities are limitless.